President Yoweri Museveni has discouraged sugarcane growing in Busoga, saying it cannot alleviate them from poverty. He, however, recommended better alternatives. The president was meeting various people, including political leaders, on his Chisozi farm, educating them on how to improve on their household income. The president revealed that the areas in the country that still grow cotton are still riddled in poverty. He said, by the time NRM came into power, the people in Ankole were only rearing cows for beef. This left most families poor. He then advised them to rear cows for milk production, an initiative he says has transformed their livelihoods.
When we came from the bush, we told these people in the cattle corridor, thank you for settling down, not moving around, but you must do income generation using the cattle industry, but in a modern way and with a chibaro.
The president also reiterated the advantage of the 4-acre model farming, which involves utilizing small pieces of land effectively and maximizing production.
We are made to grow tobacco.
Kati abantu baffe okuva mu bitundu bya West Nile, ebitundu ebya Arua, Koboko n'okuddeyo, bali baweereddwa kulima taaba.
They were doing it and they were getting some money.
Bali bakikola era nga bafuna sente, nga bafunamu ku sente.
But the money was not enough.
Naye okusinziira ku maanyi ge baateekangamu n'ebiseera bye baamalanga, sente ezo zaalinga tezimala.
The same with cotton.
Tekimu
ne pamba.
The president cautioned against land fragmentation among communities. Mbale city authorities have started implementing the demolition of old, dilapidated and condemned buildings in the city, leaving families and shop owners on these buildings stranded. The exercise kicked off today with one of the oldest buildings located on Palisa Road. Scores of families and shop owners who have been operating on this building have been left stranded following the demolition. Under the watchful eyes of police, locals say that the building was sent crumbling down in the wee hours of today morning. According to Kasim Mwaboga, the deputy city clerk, Mbale City, the city authorities took owners of these condemned, dilapidated buildings to court, which later gave them orders to carry out the demolition of the said building.
These properties are private owned, and we are having an MOU we are putting up to the Solicitor General, whereby we are insisting that all structures at least have a facelift, that is one, and then two, before we issue any lease in the CBD and outside, we want at least an approved plan from our council here of at least restoring building.
Recently, Mbale City Deputy Clerk issued a statement directing owners of these structures to put them down by themselves or else city authorities would forcefully do. Some of the buildings that were earmarked for demolition were dated between 1920 to 1950s and have been structurally condemned due to cracks. Non-government organizations at Busia border in partnership with Uganda Revenue Authority are to organize a business dinner aimed at sensitizing the Busia business community on payment of taxes for their businesses, an intervention whose ultimate goal is to create fulfilling and dignified work for over 1,000 businesses carried out at the border through smuggling. This comes at a time when most business proprietors at Busia border have raised complaints on how Uganda Revenue Authority collects taxes from them. Speaking to some business proprietors at Busia border, like Wandume Chibedi, the chairperson business proprietors and overseers at Busia Customs, he said that the high taxes have made their businesses cripple.
The government comes down, they're not just being high gear at Kampala there, and they decide out for people when Kasio suffer. Let them come, let calm down, they reduce the taxes, people will get business.
Katumba Wilson, the head of domestic taxes at Busia Customs, cautioned traders against smuggling goods into their country. He says, through the business dinner arrangement, business proprietors and overseers can get information regarding taxation in regard to their businesses.
Okay, you cannot have ferried a bag of rice in the morning, then come back at 2, come back at 4, come back. By the end of the day, you have
a container. So let's look at the limits and the frequency of this what. But I believe there are some limits on how much can be allowed as traders or as people who live by the border.
The business dinner, scheduled for 31st May 2024, is aimed at helping the business community to network as well as raise awareness of tax remittance to government by the business owners at Busia border.